Should we start the class? Is my voice audible? Okay, good, good, good. You can type your queries in the chat box. So a very good evening to all of you. I am Rushal Garg. I secured All India rank 58 in the Indian Forest Service examination 2017. Currently, I am working as an IFS officer in the Jammu Kashmir cadre. And currently, I am pursuing my on-job training. So in this session, we are particularly going to talk about Indian Forest Service examination, how to prepare mathematics optional, what your strategy should be for securing good marks in prelims. And we can talk a bit about interview and mandate of the Indian Forest Service examination. So if that is fine with all of you, we can go ahead. If you want to cover any topic, you can, any other topic, you can let me know in the chat box. We'll make it an interactive session. I'll answer your queries. So you keep mentioning your queries in the chat box. Okay, I'll cover maths optional strategy. What guided me to be an IFS officer rather than pursuing a career in any of the services in civil service examination, right? So actually I appeared for both the examinations. I was able to clear Indian Forest Service examination. Given a choice, if I would have got Indian Administrative Service, Indian Foreign Service or Indian Police Service, I would have opted for these three services. Barring these three services, if I would have got any other service, I would have opted Indian Forest Service over those services. Yashwardhan, is it clear? First, I'll start. First, I'll start with strategy for prelims. Okay, so we should start for strategy for mathematics optional. So we have six topics in paper one. Ordinary differential equation, linear algebra, calculus, vectors, dynamics and statistics, and 3D geometry. The easiest of all these topics is linear algebra. Then the other topics which are easy are differential equation, calculus, and 3D geometry, as well as vectors is also easy. So you'll face toughness in dynamics and statistics. Rest of the topics are easy. So for linear algebra, I refer to Shom series book. Linear algebra is one of the easiest topics, and you can cover this topic in 10 to 15 days. Some do's and don'ts for first attempt math strategy for prelims. What problems we face while writing maths optional examination. So I'll answer one by one. I'll answer all of your queries one by one. So I'll take what problems we face while writing maths optional examination. First problem is that if we don't have sufficient practice in mathematics, we'll not be able to answer all the questions. We'll not be able to reach the final answers. So we should have sufficient practice so that we are able to reach the final answer. And we can good mark, we can get good marks. If you are not able to reach final answer, will not get very good marks. The marks depend on the finality of the answer, the accuracy of the answer. If you have written all the steps correctly, but your answer is not correct, you'll lose marks. You'll lose a huge amount of marks. So the main thing that you have to focus is that you have to practice a lot. You should get the answer in very first attempt, because the space in the examination paper is very limited. For one question, you will get only one page. And if you don't get the right answer in the very first attempt, you will lose out on space and you can't attempt the question again. So you should be very, very perfect in solving the questions. How much time you could devote to maths after prelims? So basically, if you are ready with mathematics before prelims, I think still you need to give around 5 to 6 hours daily for mathematics optional after prelims for 90 to 100 days regularly. 3 to 4 hours for GS, 5 to 6 hours for mathematics optional. If you can give 5 to 6 hours for mathematics optional, you will be able to perform very good in the mains examination. You will score a high proportion of marks in optional as compared to the GS subjects. How to supplement Indian Civil Maths optional notes? So basically what you have to do is you can refer to Indian Civil Maths optional notes as well as the books. So first you can go through the Indian Civil Maths optional notes, prepare the basic concepts from there. When you have command over the questions, you can go back to the books regarding those topics and try some advanced levels of questions. So day by day, the difficulty of maths optional paper is increasing. So I would recommend you to first go through the Indian Civil's maths optional notes as well as the classroom series lectures. And once the syllabus is complete, you can go to the advanced type of questions from the books. That will give you command over the subject. Practice from where? So I'll give you the book list for all the 13 topics. All the 13 topics. What are the things that you regretted in and you thought must have done in the starting? So first I'll give you the book list for the math optional examination paper one. So ordinary differential equation can be covered from MD Rai Sanghania book. So that is a very good book. All the questions from that book should be practiced. Differential equation is a tough topic, tough as in it takes effort to reach the final answer. So you can practice from MD Rai Sanghania book to develop command over this subject. For linear algebra, you can refer to Shom series 3000 problems book. You can cover all the 3000 problems and you will have a very good command over the linear algebra subject. For 3D geometry, P.N. Chatterjee book is there for 3D geometry. P.N. Chatterjee is a very good book. Most of the topics from 3D geometry, you can keep the syllabus of 3D geometry with yourself and you should pick the topics. 3D geometry covers the P.N. Chatterjee covers the 3D geometry book. P.N. Chatterjee covers the 3D geometry book very, very vastly. 3D geometry can be covered from P.N. Chatterjee. What you can do is you can keep the syllabus of 3D geometry with yourself and check those topics from the P.N. Chatterjee book, and you can do all the questions whatever is relevant to the syllabus. Which book you referred for Laplace transforms? I covered from Indian Civil's math lectures, and I googled a few previous year questions and their solutions. That's what I did for Laplace transforms. First I referred to Sir's lectures for Laplace transforms, then I solved some previous year problems. I didn't refer any specific book for Laplace trans- transform. Preparation of modern algebra. So modern algebra, there are two sources that I refer to. One is Khanna and Bhambri book. And second is, there is a book of group theory as well as ring theory by R. Kumar for BA, BSc students. These two sources should be sufficient for preparation of modern algebra. Modern algebra is a tough topic. It needs time to cover and it needs a lot of practice. So I'll recommend you to start with group theory by R. Kumar, then finish ring theory by R. Kumar, and then proceed to Khanna and Bhambri book. So I'll deal with paper one, then we'll move to paper two. Regarding paper one, linear algebra, I have told you the source. For ordinary differential equation, I have told you the source. And then I have told you the source for 3D geometry as well. For vector algebra, what you can do is you can refer to Sir's videos, video lectures, as well as you can refer to Krishna series book. Vector algebra is a very easy topic and it can be finished within a week. So what I'll recommend you to do is refer to Sir's video lectures and then proceed with Krishna series book and then try some previous year questions. For dynamics and statics, first of all, it's a tough topic to comprehend. I refer to Sir's lectures completely for dynamics and statics. When I developed some understanding of the topic, I referred to Krishna series book for dynamics as well as for statics. Some of the topics like motion in a circular orbit, Kepler's laws, work energy, these are important topics for from dynamics and statics. These should be covered thoroughly. Can math be prepared by doing job and BSc simultaneously? While doing a job or while pursuing BSc, I think if you're pursuing BSc in mathematics, then it should not be a problem. And while doing job, if you can spare around 6 to 7 hours a day for 6 months, I think it should be more than sufficient. Now coming to paper two. Paper two, some of the important topics are modern algebra, real analysis, modern algebra and real analysis. These are time consuming topics and will consume almost, I think I missed calculus in paper one. For calculus in paper one, you can refer to differential calculus book by Krishna series or by Shanti Narayan. And for integral calculus, you can refer to Krishna series book. Calculus is an easy topic. You can refer to Sir's lectures and then can switch to differential calculus book by Shanti Narayan and then integral calculus book by Krishna series. Now coming to paper two, modern algebra and real analysis will consume around 50% of your time. These topics are tough topics, but you cannot afford to leave them in the examination. So you need to cover them completely. Each and every part should be covered thoroughly. For modern algebra, I told you the technique. You can refer to easy sources like R. Kumar, group theory by R. Kumar, then ring theory by R. Kumar, and then you can refer to Khanna and Bhambri. For real analysis, the one-stop solution is Savita Malik and Aroda book for real analysis. It's an easy book. You can start doing that. And after that, you can switch to Shanti Narayan book also for analysis. The publisher is S. Chand. Then you should start tackling after completing these two big topics. You will be left with four easy topics in paper two. That is numerical analysis, linear programming, How many weeks does it take for modern algebra if we start from scratch? I think it should take 6 to 7 weeks if you start modern algebra from scratch by devoting 3 to 4 hours daily. 4 to 5 hours daily, you should be able to complete it in 40 days. Then we'll talk about easy topics in paper 2. Numerical analysis and linear programming. For numerical analysis, you can refer to a book called Jain and Iyengar. Numerical analysis is a very short topic and it can be completed within 5 to 6 days. For linear programming, we have a Krishna series book, and linear programming is also a very, very easy topic. But what matters is the accuracy. If you falter in your accuracy, you will not be able to reach the right answer. So you can refer to Krishna series book for linear programming. So for computer programming, basically I'm a computer engineering. So a computer engineering student, I was a computer engineering student. So I didn't refer to any special book, but what you can do is you can Google the basic concepts of the syllabus and you'll get an ample amount of examples for computer programming stuff. So that shouldn't be a very, very much of the problem. What should be the time allocation for maths optional questions in exam? So question 1 and 5 and 5 are compulsory, right? So you should be devoting around 40% of your time, 40 to 45% of your time for the compulsory questions. Rest of the 55% of the time should be devoted for the non-compulsory questions. First, you should first 5 to 7 minutes you should spend scanning the paper, what optional questions you will be trying in the examination, and then remaining time should be divided that 40% of the time should be spent in the compulsory questions and 55% of the time should be spent in the optional questions. Yes, I'm still giving CSE. I have appeared only once in CSE and once in Indian Forest Service examination, but I'll be appearing for the subsequent attempts in the CSE. Please keep shooting your queries. I think it will be a better method to answer, get this session forward. What was my strategy for GS during the whole preparation? My strategy for GS was that first I completed my basic books like Lakshmikant for Polity, Spectrum for Modern History, Nitin Singhania for Art and Culture, R.S. Sharma for Ancient. First I went through all these books for 3 to 4 months. Then I focused on current affairs. Then I straight away started pursuing prelims test series as well as mains test series. I extensively focused on prelims, given that I had chosen the maths optional so that I can make best use of it by appearing for CSE prelims as well as Indian Forest prelims. So I focused extensively on prelims by practicing multiple choice questions before sitting for prelim examination, I completed around 200 questions, 200 full length tests. That is around 20,000 questions before sitting for prelims examination. No, I didn't prepare whole NCERTs. I referred to only class 11th and 12th NCERTs. I didn't study class 6 to class 10 NCERTs. My second optional in Indian Forest Service was forestry, and it can be prepared within a span of 1 month. From where to do economics? Economics one-stop solution is Mrunal lectures. You can refer to the lectures by Mrunal sir. Those are comprehensive lectures. 40 lectures are there. You can watch all those lectures, and after that it can be supplemented by summaries of important documents like budget, economic survey, and newspapers. I think second optional best with mathematics is forestry, as it has a very, very short syllabus. It can be covered by referring to only one book, that is Manikandan and Prabhu. So I think second best optional is forestry, and it's highly scoring as well. I scored around 246 marks out of 400 in forestry by preparing only for 1 month. If you are, how to balance time between GS and maths if you are appearing for 2021 CSE, I think this time should be devoted for completing maths. Till November end, that is 2 months from now, you should be able to complete around 8 to 9 topics from mathematics. You can solely devote that time for preparing for mathematics. And from November to February, I think you can focus on GS, and you can stay in touch with mathematics by practicing it for 1 or 2 hours daily. And then after February to April, again, you can spend some 2 months for completing 4 topics of mathematics, but GS shouldn't be left behind in those 4 months. And in the remaining 2 months, that should be exclusively for pre. No, I didn't prepare for state services along with the Indian Forest Service examination or UPSC CSE. What if I want to appear in 2023? If you are appearing for 2023, still you have a lot of time. So you should complete, you can devote exclusively 6 to 7 months for mathematics, and then 6 to 7 months for your GS and mathematics side by side. And then you can start appearing for test series to solidify your preparation. Which all test series did I join? For prelims, I joined Insights on India test series, Vision test series. And for mains, I joined Vision test series, as well as Forum IS test series. For maths optional, I joined Indian Civils test series. I joined Vajiram and Ravi for GS CSE coaching. Do you need coaching for maths? I think by taking coaching for mathematics, it makes your job very much easier. You can understand the concepts with clarity. And once you refer to coaching material and coaching lectures, you can get a good grasp of the topics, and you will not take much time to complete the syllabus. So I think if it is good if you can go for optional coaching as well. Correct time to start the test series for prelims is 4 to 5 months, 6 months ahead of prelims. And mains test series is once you are over with the entire syllabus of GS, you can as well as maths, you can go for mains test series. Regarding essay, I'll give you certain tips. What you should do is you should read the newspaper editorials regularly. You should keep note of certain verbatims in the editorials that you should mug up by heart, and you should quote them directly in the examination hall. You should have introduction and conclusion ready for certain topics like poverty, education, health, so that you can quote them easily in your essays. This will help immensely in your essays, and you can refer to essay book by Shubhra Ranjan madam. Most of the topics, if you read all the topics in that book, you can use the content in one or the other essay in the examination hall. Coaching, whether it's offline or online, I think it hardly makes a difference. So any type of coaching for maths optional will be beneficial. In Indian Forest Service mains and CSE mains, the level of difficulty in optional subject, it's not very much difficult, very much different. The optional what we get in regarding difference in CSE mains and Indian Forest Service mains, the optional subject is not very much different. All the topics are approximately the same, and the level of difficulty is also the same. But I think there is a stark difference between GK paper of Indian Forest Service examination and general studies of civil service examination. The general studies of civil service examination are a bit analytical, but GK for Indian Forest Service examination is basically static. It's not, the questions are not very much analytical. And another major difference is that the English paper in Indian Forest Service examination is compulsory, whereas in civil service examination, it's just of qualifying nature. My background is I'm an engineer. Which coaching is best for maths optional? I think guidance by Indian Civils helped me a lot. Sir's lecture are very clear and lucid. What you can do is basically watch the lectures and supplement those lectures with the problems from books, as well as problems from books, as well as previous year problems. And what you can do is you can join Indian Civils test series, maths test series, and you can join one more maths optional test series. Whatever is you think it's good, you can go through the question papers. You can join two maths optional test series and follow Sir's lectures and books and the book sources mentioned by me. How to balance time? I am working, no time to read newspaper. Any tips? You can glance through the important topics from newspapers. If you still don't have time for reading newspaper, then you can watch Hindu analysis on Baiju's, or you can read summary of newspaper analysis given by various sites like Insights on India Forum IS, or you can refer to Baiju's Hindu analysis. Any tricks or tips you found after writing mathematics paper so that we can improve our preparation? The tips that I can give you is that you should not leave any topic of the syllabus. If you leave any topic of the syllabus, then I think you are screwed in the examination. You should cover each and every topic exhaustively. Earlier, it used to be that the questions, one set of questions used to be from one chapter, but nowadays multiple chapters come in one set of questions, so you cannot afford to leave any topic. And another tip I would like to give you is that you should start developing the habit of getting answer in one go. If you are not getting answer in one go, there will be a crunch of space in the examination hall. How deeply we should prepare for maths? I think it should be very, very exhaustive. It should be, the preparation should be very exhaustive. You should devote at least 6 months before sitting for maths optional examination. 6 months, 6 hours a day. 1,000 hours for examination. Mathematics optional. How to make notes from current affairs on regular? You don't need to make notes from current affairs on regular basis. You can refer to monthly compilations by various sources like Vision or Forum IS. If you're making notes on regular basis, then I think you would be compromising on your maths optional. So basically what you can do is highlight important things in Vision or Forum IES notes. Did you practice daily answer writing for GS and from which month? Yes, I didn't used to practice it daily, but I used to write tests very frequently, like writing 2 or 3 tests in a week. So if I had to sit in June for prelims, then I started writing prelims as well as mains tests from October previous year. So every week I used to write 2 or 3 tests, including optional, mains as well as prelims. How are you sure that a topic is complete? If this question is being asked in context of mathematics optional, if you are able to solve the previous year questions, then I think that your topic is complete. If you have studied a topic and you are able to solve all the previous year questions or 90% of the previous year questions, I think then your topic is complete. Now, being in Indian Forest Service, how are you managing your preparation for CSE? Actually, I face a lot of time crunch. What I have to do is devote some time during the night, wake up early. So my timing is around 10 a.m. to 5 p.m. So I start studying at around 7 p.m. I study till 11 p.m. Then I wake up at 5 p.m. and I study from 5 a.m. and I study from 5 a.m. to 9 a.m. You can keep asking questions. The preparation in maths optional has to be quite exhaustive. For each topic, I think you should practice 10 problems. And for each chapter, that amounts to around 100 to 150 problems. If there are 10 topics in a chapter, so 100 to 150 problems should be practiced before sitting in a test series. And then you should be practicing test series regularly. I have done an analysis taking scores of various topics, and the scaling factor in CSE and in Indian Forest Service examination is around 0.77 to 0.78. If you are writing all the answers correctly with all the proper steps and in clean writing, the scaling factor is around 0.77 to 0.78. So you can calculate appropriately that how much you need to score for getting an absolute score of 350. 0.77 is the scaling factor. I missed one question regarding preparation strategy for prelims. If you want to score high for prelims, then you should be very thorough with basic books like Lakshmikant, Spectrum, Nitin Singhania, Shankar IAS for Environment, Munal Lectures for Economy. Once you are through with these basic sources, then you should start doing prelim questions. You should practice daily current affairs questions present on websites like Forum IAS, Insights on India.com. And then you should enroll for 2 or 3 test series, or you can get test series from market. You can purchase test series from market and start practicing by yourself. I think you should solve around 15,000 to 20,000 prelim questions before sitting for prelims if you are targeting Indian Forest Service examination as well. Whatever you are comfortable with, if you want to take 2 topics, if you are comfortable, then you can take 2 topics so that it doesn't get to be monotonous doing 1 topic, or you can stick to 1 topic as well. If it is not monotony for you, you can stick to 1 topic as well. Anything you would like to share from your CSE experience on your first attempt? In CSC, I got good marks in essay, ethics, GS paper 2, 3, but I screwed GS paper 1 and maths optional paper 2. So one should be very thorough with static part of GS 1, that is history, geography, world history. And one should have a good command over maths paper 2 in CSE. Paper is a bit difficult in CSE regarding maths paper 2. You should cover each and every topic from fluid to modern algebra to real analysis. Every topic should be covered. For maths, how did you cover chapters? For most of the chapters, I relied on Indian Civil's classroom, online classroom coaching. That made my job a bit easier. I took recorded lectures from sir and I used to watch it at a fast pace. And I completed all the lectures in around two to two and a half months. And then two and a half months I devoted for preparing solving problems from basic sources of maths books. And then what I did was topic wise I started solving previous year questions, previous year 15 to 20 years questions. Whatever solutions I was not able to get, I didn't get, I used to Google those solutions, or I used to follow it up with the Indian Civil's Venkanna sir, and he helped me a lot in solving previous year questions. My source for current affairs was Vision IAS monthly compilation. I used to read newspaper regularly. Then I used to also write test series, current affair, Vision IAS test series for mains regularly. And I used to cover a lot of prelims questions from websites like Insights on India, Forum IAS. The five questions that they give daily, I used to solve them. I used to read their explanations and make and mark those in my, I used to make e-notes out of those explanations, and that was my strategy to cover current affairs. The notes that's given as type-wise questions. Can per type 2, 3 be done to get basics? Yes, you can do type 2, 3 questions and then start with previous year papers. I think it will take six months to complete your maths optional syllabus by practicing for 6 hours daily. Approximately 1000 hours to 1100 hours should be devoted for preparing for maths optional. How to manage limited answer space in exam? Can we make partition of that page while writing answer? I don't think making a partition will be a very, very good idea. What you can do is you can write in a smaller font, and the only panacea to resolve this the space problem in the examination is to be very, very perfect in answering the questions. You need to practice a lot so that you can hit the right answer in the first go. I didn't cover the entire newspaper daily. I used to glance through the only through the important topics by referring to websites like insightsonindia.com. They used to give a list of important reads every day, important topics every day. I used to cover only those topics. while giving pre, I'll tell you, for if you are targeting Indian Forest Service, you have to be very smart while attempting pre. You need to eliminate options and then take some calculated risks. If you're targeting Indian Forest Service pre, I think you should be able to attempt more than 85 to 90% of the preliminary examination. If you are sure with 60 to 65% of the questions, you should attempt all of those questions, and then remaining 20% questions, then you should take calculated risks. You should eliminate options based on your knowledge, use intelligent guessworking, and rest of the 20% questions should be attempted like that. Then only you would be able to score very high for prelim examination for Indian Forest Service. Regarding mains also, there is examination pressure. But once you are in the examination hall, and if you are able to solve one or two sets of questions in mathematics paper, then all the things fall in one place and you are able to score good marks in the examination. For governance and ethics, I refer to Pawan Kumar sir. Pawan Kumar sir's notes. He teaches public administration, governance and ethics. You can easily get those notes from any of the shops in Rajendra Nagar. You can note it down, Pawan Kumar sir, for governance and ethics. I scored very good marks in ethics in 2017 attempt by referring only to his notes. Pawan Kumar IAS. While preparing for CSC, I left dynamics and statics and fluid mechanics chapters, but I paid heavily for that because I was not able to attempt those questions in CSE examination. Then before appearing for Indian Forest examination, in the 1 month, I prepared both those topics by referring to Venkanna sir's video lectures, Indian Civil's video lectures. and I was able to cover a huge amount of questions on those two topics in the Indian Forest Service examination. Is it normal if I am struggling with maths initially, like in first two? Yes, it is very much normal if you're struggling with maths in initial 1-2 months. Even if you're struggling after 5-6 months, it's very, very much normal. If you start doing test series, if you're not getting very good marks, it's not a reason to get disheartened. I think after 8 to 9 months of consistent practice, I'm very sure that you'll be doing wonders in mathematics. I used to struggle even after 5 months of preparation. Can I get all your study material list for? You can check my Quora answer for all the study material list. I have given the all the book sources list on Quora. You can search Rushal Garg there and you will get all the book list for GS, Forestry, Mathematics. I appeared for 2017 examination. It was not the case in 2017 examination. The answer space was very limited in 2017 examination. It was good space in CSE examination, but in Indian Forest Service examination, it was very much limited. From every topic, there is an unexpected question in maths. How did you deal with that? There may be an unexpected questions, but the only answer to that unexpected questions is sufficient practice. I think every model of the question is from previous year questions. So if you have covered previous year questions, almost all the models, that 90% of the models are covered in the future examinations as well. So if you have covered previous year question paper, I think 90% of the questions you will be able to solve. And if you're able to solve 90% of the questions and 0.77, 0.78 is the scaling factor, you'll get 70% of the total 500 marks. That amounts to 350, 340 marks. And that will be very, very sufficient marks to get you through CSC through all the stages. Sometimes in math optional CSE questions are asked out of syllabus. Out of syllabus will be for everyone. If the question is out of syllabus, then it will be for everyone. The marking is relative. It hardly makes a difference. It will be for everyone. Being a beginner starting with current affairs from newspaper, I can see most of the topics from GS portion, which, as I said, being a beginner is hard to understand. How to manage current affairs? Should I complete GS first? No, you should complete GS first. You should do both these things simultaneously. What you can do is go on insights on india.com. They have sorted out each and every topic according to the paper and syllabus. You should refer to those already compiled lists and start preparing according to those lists. What you can do is, like, for example, the question is from Parliament. Today's current affair topics in the newspaper is from Parliament. What you can do is, on that day, read the Parliament chapter from Polity, a book, Lakshmikant, and then cover that Parliament topic from that insights on india.com, current topic from insights on india.com. How to revise current affairs during prelim? Solving questions, prelim questions, pre questions as well as mains questions is the best strategy, and revise the monthly compilations of the current affairs examination. Refer to only one source of monthly compilation, that is Vision or Insights, whatever is comfortable for you, and revise them over and over again. Why is scaling there in maths optional? If you have attempted everything right, why don't you get full marks, especially in maths optional? Scaling is there because in the humanities optional, you cannot get full marks. So everyone should be at par. That is why there is scaling in maths optional. If you do 500 out of 500 correct, but if someone answers 500 out of 500 in sociology, he'll be getting 300 marks. You'll be getting 500. So it will not be fair in competition. So there are several statistical procedures to bring the sociology student or humanities student at par with mathematics. That is why scaling is done in mathematics, physics, or any other science optional examination. For maths optional candidate, which language will help more for interview? As in, I didn't understand your question. Can you repeat your question? Whatever you are comfortable in speaking in, you can refer to. You can answer in English, you can answer in Hindi, you can use a mixture of both. I am not very much comfortable in speaking in English, so I refer to both English, Hindi during my interview. I think it doesn't make a difference. I know many of the people who have failed that they'll appear for interview in Hindi or English, but they have used a mixture of both the languages and they have got good marks in interview. Any other questions? How can we connect with you in the future for guidance? You can text me on Facebook, you can text me on Instagram, whatever you feel comfortable. You can contact me through indiancivils.com as well. No, I didn't face any maths related question in interview. I didn't face. People generally only a few candidates face question related to their optionals. I think it's not a trend in UPSC civil service as well as forest service interview to get questions on mathematics or other optional subjects. Visitor 738876, when are you planning to appear for examination? Yes, two revision should be sufficient to start with GS answer writing. Or what you can do is prepare one topic and then simultaneously start GS answer writing. Like if you prepare, if you have done prepared the topic fundamental rights, and if you face any question related to fundamental rights on if you get a sample question on sites on india.com, try to answer that question. Visitor 738876, yes, you can very much complete the syllabus for 2021 attempt. Approximately 9.5 months, 290 days are left for 290 days are left for UPSC CSC prelim 2021. You can devote 150 to 180 days for mathematics, optional 6 hours a day, 4 hours a day for GS. That should be more than sufficient. In mains examination, shall we pay more attention to optional ethics essay? Yes, definitely, definitely. Optional ethics essay are very scoring. You should pay more attention to optional ethics essay as well as GS1. As well as GS1, GS2 and GS3, people devote 60% of their time in preparing for GS2, GS3, and the reward is very low. Reward is very low. But if you devote 60 to 70% of your time in optional ethics essay and GS1, I can guarantee you can get a rank in top 100. GS2 and GS3, I think only 30 to 20% of the time should be devoted for GS2, GS3. But people, what they do is GS2, GS3 devote around 60% of the time, and that is a recipe for disaster in the examination. I did not cover static portion. I am from 2020 and how to write answers daily. Daily answer writing is not based on static portion. If you read an editorial, it's basic understanding, basic common sense. And if you want to frame an answer out of that, you can easily write an answer. And side by side, you can start reading static portion and start supplementing the answer with your static knowledge as well. If they ask on mass type question, any model question, what they can ask is, like, there is no Nobel Prize in mathematics. They ask in what is the equivalent of Nobel Prize in mathematics. So Fields Medal is there. Who was the recent winner of Fields Medal? Something like that, on those lines, something they can ask. They will not ask very much technical. In which field you will like to work the most? I mean, what is your dream to improve our social condition? I would like to work in the field of health and education. Those are the two fields which affect immensely from poorest of the poor to the richest of the rich. So I like to work in the field of health and education. For modern history, is R.S. Sharma enough? For modern history, I refer to Spectrum as well as Bipin Chandra. I did not refer to R.S. Sharma. For me, Bipin Chandra and Spectrum was enough. Yes, my main aim is to get into IAS. I can work for health and education through Indian Forest Service as well, because Indian Forest Service officers also get an opportunity on deputation to work in various ministries in the state government as well as central government. But the sphere in IAS is much wider than Indian Forest Service, and there are much higher chances for getting deputation into various departments through IAS than Indian Forest Service. The main mandate of Indian Forest Service is to implement National Forest Policy, but as you reach the higher stages of your career, you get an opportunity to work on deputation in various ministries at the central level as well as at the state level. So after IAS, I think the officers from the Indian Forest, the number of officers from the Indian Forest Service are maximum to be impaneled at the level of Joint Secretary and Additional Secretary. I think if you are from general category, you should score more than 120 marks consistently in prelims if you are targeting Indian Forest Service pre-examination. More than 130 consistently. Nothing below 120. and your average should be around 130. If you're targeting only CSC, then 115 should be the criteria. 115. OBC, I think there is only a difference of 3 to 4 marks. So you can subtract 3-4 marks from the cutoff in prelims. In mains, it's around 30 to 40 marks, but in prelims, it's around only 2 to 3 marks. Yes, you can ask a personal question. Source to correct your answers, you can catch hold of any teacher or a person who has qualified civil service examination or Indian Forest examination to give you feedback on your essays or answer writing. Yes, I can be your mentor. I can be your mentor. No issue on that. If you're preparing for an examination, I'll recommend you to join a mess so that you can save on time for exam preparation. Cooking yourself will consume a lot of time. I think we are. Is there any other question? I think we are done for the day. I wish you all the best. I'll focus on mathematics for my next attempt. I'll focus over interview and mathematics for my next CSE attempt. Okay, thank you. It was nice interacting with you. Thank you. Thanks a lot.